Hello dear students, hope you all are fine. We have covered carbohydrates. After complete study of carbohydrates, we will shift to carbohydrate metabolism, which comes under unit 2. Under carbohydrate metabolism, we will study different processes like glycogenesis. Genesis means synthesis. Glycogenesis means synthesis of glycogen. Glycogenolysis, lysis means breakdown. So breakdown of glycogen into glucose is glycogenolysis. Synthesis of glycogen from glucose is known as glycogenesis. Then we will study how glucose is degraded in our body to produce energy. The process involves three different steps, that is, first is glycolysis, then second is oxidation of pyruvate, third is TCA cycle. Besides this, we will also study an alternative pathway of glucose metabolism, that is hexose monophosphate shunt. Before I start with carbohydrate metabolism, I want to tell you basic information, that is how enzymes they are named and how these processes they are named. Hydration means addition of water. Dehydration means removal of water. So D means removal of water. Hydrogenation means addition of hydrogen. Dehydrogenation means removal of hydrogen. Phosphorylation means addition of phosphate. Dephosphorylation means removal of phosphate. So that's how processes they are named. Then for naming of enzymes, generally majority of enzymes they are named by taking name of substrate plus name of reaction, and in the end suffix -ase is placed. So this will be clear to you when we will name different enzymes. So enzymes, they are named after name of substrate. A part is taken from name of substrate. Then name of reaction is added to it. Then in the end, ACE is put. But some enzymes, they are named after taking the name of product plus name of reaction and placing suffix ACE. So this will be clear to you when we will study the process. So first of all, we are taking up glycogenesis. Genesis, I have told you, this is synthesis. Synthesis of glycogen from glucose when the blood sugar level is high. This process is known as glycogenesis. It mainly takes place in liver and muscle cells. So naturally, this is the synthesis of glycogen from glucose. So here, the process mainly requires a glycogen primer. Glycogen primer means a very short glycogen molecule. So how this process takes place? The process is completed in 5 steps: phosphorylation, rearrangement, dephosphorylation, condensation and branching. You have studied structure of glucose, which is a monosaccharide having 6 carbons. You have studied the structure of glycogen, which is made up of nearly 30,000 glucose units held by alpha-1,4 and alpha-1,6 linkage. So while studying this process, you should keep in mind what is the structure of glucose, what is the structure of glycogen. So glucose first of all undergoes phosphorylation. Phosphorylation, I have told you, addition of phosphate. Phosphate is taken from ATP. ATP after giving its phosphate changes into ADP. And this phosphate attaches to glucose at 6th position, forming glucose-6-phosphate. So name of enzyme is gluco. This we have taken from the name of substrate. Kinase is the enzyme which is involved in the attachment of phosphate group. You can also call it as glucophosphorylase. That is also correct. So we are writing over here glucokinase. So enzyme naming always ends in -ase. So this is the first step. Now glucose-6-phosphate, in glucose-6-phosphate, phosphate group shifts from 6th carbon to 1st carbon. The process is known as rearrangement. This requires presence of magnesium ions like the first step. And the name of enzyme is phosphoglucomutase because it involves rearrangement shifting from 6th position to 1st position. Next step is dephosphorylation. But it involves the participation of uridine triphosphate. So uridine triphosphate loses one phosphate plus one phosphate detaches from glucose 1-phosphate. It means pyrophosphate group is removed. Uridine triphosphate after losing its phosphate changes into uridine diphosphate. which then combines with glucose to form uridine diphosphate glucose. So pyrophosphate group is removed. So what is the name of enzyme over here is, we have taken it by this method, that is name of product, uridine diphosphate glucose pyrophosphorylase, because it involves removal of pyrophosphate group. Pyrophosphorylase. So it must be clear to you that how enzymes they are named. Next step is condensation. Now this uridine diphosphate glucose condenses with glycogen primer. Glycogen primer, I have told you, this is a small glycogen molecule having few alpha 1,4 and alpha 1,6 linkages. Otherwise, glycogen is a very large molecule having very large number of alpha 1,4 and alpha 1,6 linkages. So, uridine diphosphate glucose reacts with glycogen primer. The glucose from uridine diphosphate glucose, it attaches to glycogen primer at one end forming alpha 1,4 linkage. So, this glycogen primer becomes longer by one glucose unit and uridine diphosphate is released. So, glucose from here attaches to glycogen primer forming alpha 1,4 linkage. So, glycogen molecule which is a primer, it becomes longer by one glucose unit and the name of enzyme over here is glycogen synthetase because it involves synthesis of glycogen. Now, in this way, 1,4 linkages they are added. But I have told you at branching point we require 1,6 linkage. So branching enzyme which is dextrin-dextranase. If you can't remember dextrin-dextranase, simply write down branching enzyme. Branching enzyme detaches one glucose from alpha 1,4 linkage and forms alpha 1,6 linkage. So I have shown over here diagrammatically. So for example, this is a glycogen primer. Here these are alpha 1,4 linkages, this is the alpha 1,6 linkage. Now, as the result of condensation, one more glucose molecule is added over here forming alpha 1,4 linkage. So, this was the glycogen primer, this is the glycogen primer which has increased in length by one glucose unit. Now, the branching enzyme will remove this alpha 1,4 linkage and it will develop alpha 1,6 linkage. So, now 1,4 glucose linkage is broken and it is converted into 1,6 linkage. A new branching point is added. Now again more glucose unit will be added over here by this process, by condensation. And more branching points will be formed by the branching enzyme. With the result of which, this glycogen primer, which is a short molecule that will ultimately develop into a large glycogen molecule having many alpha 1,4 and alpha 1,6 linkages. So this formation of glycogen from glucose is known as glycogenesis.